I do not have many meaningful tattoos, but this one, like this little bird, got caught here in the barbed wire, and yeah, it breaks free, and I'm a free spirit, and I want to break free all the time, and yeah, this means a lot to me.
Hi, welcome to another episode of Face Tattoo Talks. My name is Joachim Stels and I've been photographing people with face tattoos for the past 5 years now. If you're interested in checking out my work, I'll leave a link to my Instagram down below. This year, I'm also challenging myself to do one video interview each month of the year. Last month, I shared a very interesting video with body modification and tattoo artist Eugenia Delphine. And for this episode, I decided to invite Ivy Van Hoek, a German tattoo artist based in Nuremberg, to photograph and video interview her as well. I already photographed her husband David a couple of years ago for my first book, Jobstoppers, A Collection of Face Tattoo Portraits Volume 1, and Ivy will definitely be part of Volume 2. For next month's interview, I'm planning to interview Eiko Hosten, a suspension facilitator as well as a piercing artist. If you like these types of videos, please feel free to like it, to share it with your friends who might also find it interesting, to subscribe to my channel if you want to stay updated about future videos and interviews, and maybe leave a comment if you want me to interview something particular in the future as well. So much for the intro. I really hope you enjoy my interview with Ivy Van Hoek, and see you in the next video. Bye bye. So please introduce yourself.
Hey, I'm Ivy. I'm from Nuremberg and I'm a tattoo artist.
Welcome to my home.
Thank you.
What type of tattoos do you specialize in?
Well, I tried, like during the last few years, I tried different styles of tattoos because I tried to avoid limiting myself, and I was really into the diversity. But now I'm really into focusing on ornamental stuff and blackout tattoos because bold will hold.
That's true. When did you first get into tattooing? What was your like first contact with tattoos?
Well, that was my dream since like I was 15, I think. I started learning graphic design, and I always was so much into tattooing. I told my parents when I was like 17, I'm gonna have my own tattoo studio one day, and you know, they were laughing at me. And when I turned like 23, I got pregnant. And that was the time when I decided to just started tattooing. I learned it myself, and my husband David, he ordered all the tattoo stuff, and he was like, do it now or you will never do it. And I came home one day, and he was like waiting for me in the kitchen, and he was like, and now you're gonna start tattooing. And here's my leg, and now try it. Just, yeah, do it. And then I just did it, and I practiced my whole, like, pregnancy because I had some pressure, like time pressure. I didn't want to go back to my normal job, and that was my dream, like, for years, and I just started doing it. So, I had, like, 1 year to learn a lot about it, and then I was like, fuck that, I'm gonna start my own business. And yeah, I just truly believed in myself. And yeah, that was when I was 24, so 7 years ago.
Nice.
Yeah.
What was the first thing you tattooed on David's leg?
It was like a knife, right? I think like a dagger through a heart, like very traditional. Yeah, it was fun and it wasn't that bad. Like I expected it to be super bad, but yeah, we were surprised. It turned out really good.
Is it still there or is it covered?
It's covered. It's covered with a blackout. Yeah, blackout tattoo.
What was your own first tattoo?
My own first tattoo actually was like a tribal tattoo when I was only 15 years old. And I really regret that because I needed to cover it like, I don't know, maybe 7 years later. And the cover up is like crap. It's really bad. And now I'm trying to cover it again. It's fucking painful, man.
Where was it?
Like on my hip here, like classical, you know. How do you call it? Like a tramp stamp? But here, this area. Yeah.
What was your first face tattoo?
My first face tattoo was like the lettering above my eyebrow. It says Nightingale in German, Nachtigall. because I really like that bird. It's like the bird for my birth month, May. And yeah, I really like that they are like singing at night. And yeah, it's just a nice bird. Bounty tattoo. He's from Nuremberg and he's my favorite artist, to be honest. Almost all my tattoos were done by him. And yeah, I really trust him. Yeah, he's amazing.
Can you tell me a little bit about the...
Yes, of course. This is, to be honest, my favorite tattoo. It's done by Emmy. She works at Chalador in London. And yeah, I used to tattoo there. That's why I know her. And I really wanted her to do it because she does like hand poke tattoos. And a few years ago, I had like a little experience, like an awakening kind of thing. And yeah, I really wanted to remind myself to trust my intuition. And yeah, this symbolizes yeah, the meaning of it because it's placed at my like third eye. And yeah, I love it. I see it every day.
I remember as well, we have script under your chin as well.
Yeah. That script means Vala Morghulis. It's from the series Game of Thrones. I'm a little nerdy sometimes. Yeah, it was like a gap here and I was just being annoyed of it. And I was like, very spontaneous. I said to my tattoo artist Bounty, I was like, hey, let's do that lettering, please. Yeah, it was so much fun.
Some of your other tattoos that you have by either by Bounty or by different artists?
Well, I really like my palm tattoo by Belmore. He's from Vienna. It was like the most painful tattoo I ever got, and also the blackout. Yeah, I wanted to get rid of my chest piece a few years ago, so I did that black out cover up by Danilo. He is based in Poland. But he was visiting Nuremberg, so I was like, hey, let's do this. And yeah, it was like only two sessions. First session, he did like the freehand drawing and outlines. And the other session, we did the blackout. And oh man, I really needed a break after tattooing this because it was so painful, like at night. It was everything so swollen and I wasn't sure how to position myself. And at some point, I just started crying because I couldn't cope with the pain anymore. Yeah, we still need to finish that part on my belly. So it's not all done, but I need to prepare myself for doing this. You need to be mentally prepared for tattoos like this. Yeah. Yeah.
And on your arms, some of them or all of them are by Bounty as well?
Yes, I even got his name tattooed here, Bounty tattoo. Yeah, I love them. I really like the style. It's just, yeah, timeless, you know.
Can you tell me what you have?
This is like Krampus. I'm not sure how to explain this in English.
Is it like a demon type that steals children?
With, yeah, right, for Santa. Like Santa's body. Yeah, who steals children. And yeah, I really like the bird. I'm like, I do not have many meaningful tattoos, but this one, like this little bird, got caught here in the barbed wire, and yeah, it breaks free. And I'm just really, I'm a free spirit, and I want to break free all the time. And yeah, this means a lot to me.
Okay, yeah. And tell me about the knuckles.
The knuckles, you cannot see it properly right now because of the rings, but it says Van Hoek, and this is like a partner tattoo with my husband. We didn't want to have rings for marriage, so we decided to have a tattoo, and this is our artist's name, and yeah, it means a lot.
At what point and why did you say, like, okay, I'm going to go for the full, the blackout of the arms? Was it like, were you tired of what's underneath, or were you just drawn to the aesthetic of having a blackout tattoo?
Yeah. I really didn't like my tattoos anymore, like the style, it was realism, which was great if you like it, but yeah, I just wasn't into it anymore, so I decided to cover it, and I'm really into blackout tattoos. Yeah, I would like to have more, but I still love these tattoos by Bounty, so I think I'm not gonna cover it, but yeah, maybe a bit more on my belly, and yeah.
Tell me a bit about your back piece.
So my back piece was also made by Bounty, by my favorite artist. And it's like the Hindu goddess Saraswati. And it symbolizes creativity. And yeah, I really like her.
Like in daily life, do people confront you or do people act weird about having face tattoos to you? Or is it quite okay?
Yeah, people do act weird sometimes, especially like teachers at the school of our son. And yeah, sometimes it's annoying and difficult because people look at you like you're a criminal, or yeah, just they do not have, like, they don't speak to you in a respectful way because of how you look like. And this is sad sometimes, but also you get so many compliments sometimes, and people tell us that we're like a great family and we look like cool parents, and yeah, that makes me happy all the time. But yeah, you have both sides.
Yeah, I think the key is not to worry too much about the negative.
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's it.
There will always be people that don't.
Yeah, judging. People always judge, but yeah. I don't really care about it.
If it's not about your tattoos.
It's, yeah, something, it's something else, right? Yeah.
You also have, together with your husband, you also have a clothing brand. Can you tell me a little bit about that? Do you do designs yourself? Or?
Yeah. We started having our own clothing brand during lockdown because of COVID. And yeah, because you had no other option to make money. And yeah, I do the designs myself, and we drop a new design for a t-shirt or hoodie or whatever every then and now. So it's kind of a limited thing, and yeah, we just want to keep it a bit special. And also, I'm always busy. I'm a mom and working, and it's sometimes really hard to find time for doing another design for the t-shirt or whatever. But yeah, it's a passion. I like it. Also, it's good to have it, right? When you go to like a convention or whatever, like for promotion. Yeah.
Do you have any specific tattoos planned in the future for yourself?
Yes. I'm actually thinking about doing a second layer. I hate myself already for doing that because it's so painful. It's going to be painful. But like a second layer in red, maybe. I'm not done. It's like a journey of self realization. Yeah, we will see.
Everything in time.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you so much for taking the time to do this.
Thank you.
And it was lovely seeing you both of you again.
Thank you so much. I really enjoyed doing that.
Happy to hear that.